Okay, right next to the black is low beam. That should be the black. Right next to the black is low beam. Yes, that is the blue and red wire. So let's turn this on. So we have 12 volts. We've confirmed the blue and red wire is low beam. And key on, it is cold with the brights. Right next to it is the blue and white wire. That should be high beam. No voltage. High beam confirmed. Turned on. Turned off. So I'm gonna plug it into the blue wire. So I have a blue wire right there. So let's find out what it does. Let's power up. The blue wire is hot. Hot with the key on. Cold when brights are on. So now, look down in here, we have a, So this one here is in the, there's two red and blue wires, red stripe, blue wires. There's two red, white stripe, blue wires. So that's it. There's no purple wire in here. All right, we're gonna cut this off at 2.5 inches. So let's get them all lined up the best we can. just like that. Okay, next to the black is the brown. And then the white. I did make the black wire a little too long. Mink locks in place. Take this one. Pinch the end there, sealed. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that up in there, just like that. Squeeze it off. Yep. So it's got glue inside. This is that environmental one. Use a lower, whatever. Beat. Go ahead and connect this back up. Click. I got this here and this back here. just like that. Look, fits in perfectly. As short as you think I cut them, as short as I cut them, it lays in there. All right, low beam. High beam. Low beam. Moment of truth. Low beams are good. I also have my day running lights. Well, I guess not. Okay, we'll fix that. All right, let's bring out the Angry Bird. Believe it or not, steel pins are the best. Get it in there, like that. There we go. Sometimes if you have a rear locking device, use the steel pin to push it out, but mink, there we go. Mink locks in place. Take this one. Get down a little bit. Mink. Mink. Pinch the end there, sealed.